Good morning. Good morning and welcome to St. Michael the Archangel Catholic Church. We thank you for your presence with us today. If you have not already done so, please take this opportunity to silence your cell phone. If you'd like to make a donation to St. Michael's, we invite you to use the blue envelopes in the pew and place it in the collection basket. By doing this, it will ensure your entire donation will remain with the parish. Alternatively, if you'd like to help us with our Catholic faith appeal, please use the yellow CFA envelope for your donation and drop that in the collection basket. Today, there will be a second collection for the residents of Maui. Please place those donations in the second basket that is passed, and your generation is greatly appreciated. Today, we're celebrating the 21st Sunday of Ordinary Time, and our presider is our pastor, Father Michael Cannon. And at this time, I invite you to stand to join in singing our opening song, number 924, as we gather at your table. As we gather at your table, as we listen to your word, help us know, God, your presence. Let our hearts and minds be stirred. Nourish us with sacred story, till we claim it as our own. Teach us through this holy banquet how to make love's victory known. Turn our worship into witness in the sacrament of life. Send us forth to love and serve you, bringing peace where there is strife. Give us, Christ, your great compassion to forgive as you forgave. May we still behold your image in the world you died to save.
We gather in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. The grace and peace of God the Father and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. Good morning, everyone. And I too welcome everyone to church this Sunday morning. As always, I welcome those of you who are parishioners with us here at the parish. We welcome visitors joining us today, and if there are members of other faiths, other Christian denominations, you're very welcome. Thank you for praying with us this morning. And we also extend a welcome to those of you joining us remotely from across the nation and beyond our borders. Thank you for praying with us today. To prepare ourselves for the Mass, let's take a moment as we call to mind our sins, as we ask God for forgiveness, as we ask God for strength. I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and in what I have failed to do, through my fault, through my most grievous fault. Therefore I ask, Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Amen. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of goodwill. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you, we give you thanks for your great glory. Lord God, heaven and on earth peace to people of goodwill. Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world. Receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father. Have mercy on us. Glory to God in the highest, and on earth to people of goodwill. For you alone are the Holy One, you alone are the Lord, you alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Amen, amen. Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of good will.
Let us pray. O God, who caused the minds of the faithful to unite in a single purpose, grant your people to love what you command and to desire what you promise, that amid the uncertainties of this world, our hearts may be fixed on that place where true gladness is found, through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. Thus says the Lord to Shebna, master of the palace, I will thrust you from your office and pull you down from your station. On that day, I will summon my servant Eliakim, son of Hilkiah. I will clothe him with your robe and gird him with your sash and give him over to your authority. He shall be a father to the inhabitants of Jerusalem and to the house of Judah. I will place the key of the house of David on Eliakim's shoulder. When he opens, no one shall shut. When he shuts, no one shall open. I will fix him like a peg in a sure spot to be a place of honor for his family. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Lord, your love is eternal. Do not forsake the work of your hands. Lord, your love is eternal. Do not forsake the work of your hands. I will give thanks to you, O Lord, with all my heart. For you have heard the words of my mouth. In the presence of the angels I will sing your praise. I will worship at your holy temple. Lord, your love is eternal. Do not forsake the work of your hands. I will give thanks to your name.
because of your kindness and your truth. When I called, you answered me. You built up strength within me. Lord, your love is eternal. Do not forsake the work of your hands. The Lord is exalted, yet the lowly he sees, and the proud he knows from afar. Your kindness, and Lord, endures forever. Forsake not the work of your hands. Lord, your love is eternal. Do not forsake the work of your hands.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Romans. Oh, the depths of the riches and wisdom and knowledge of God! How inscrutable are his judgments, and how unsearchable his ways. For who has known the mind of the Lord, or who has been his counselor, or who has given the Lord anything that he may be repaid? For from him, and through him, and for him are all things. To him be glory forever. Amen. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Alleluia, 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 alleluia. You are Peter, and upon this rock I will build my church, and the gates of the netherworld shall not prevail against it. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew. Jesus went into the region of Caesarea Philippi, and he asked his disciples, "Who do people say that the Son of Man is?" They replied, "Some say John the Baptist, others Elijah, still others Jeremiah, or one of the prophets." He said to them, "But who do you say that I am?" Simon Peter said in reply, "You are the Christ, the Son of the living God." Jesus said to him in reply, "Blessed are you, Simon, son of Jonah, for flesh and blood has not revealed this to you, but my heavenly Father. And so I say to you, you are Peter, and upon this rock I will build my church, and the gates of the netherworld shall not prevail against it. I will give you the keys to the kingdom of heaven. Whatever you bind on earth shall be bound in heaven, and whatever you loose on earth shall be loosed in heaven." Then he strictly ordered his disciples to tell no one that he was the Christ. My friends, the gospel of the Lord. I recently read an article about a priest in a rural diocese here in the United States who was working predominantly with high school and college students. And a part of his remit, if you will, was that he conducted weekend retreats for the students. At one stage, he got into some hot water. On the Friday night of the retreats, he would tell the students that by the end of the weekend, they should make a decision about their Christian faith. They should either embrace it or reject it. As you can imagine, this didn't go down very well with a lot of the parents. But the priest replied that Catholic youth have to make all sorts of decisions in regard to career, lifestyle, residence, studies, relationships, and so much more. Religion, he contended, fell by the wayside, either not important enough on which to make a decision, or relegated to the personal shelf of neglect, as he put it, to be possibly taken down and dusted years later for a hatching, a matching, or a dispatching, in other words, for a baptism, or a marriage, or a death. And the priest argued that this was not good enough. After years of faith formation, the church had to take the risk of calling for a personal decision for faith. And he pointed out that many of our Christian brothers and sisters make this call to their young people. Well, quite a number of the students in his group, he was particularly good at what he did, but quite a number of his students in his group consciously chose membership in the church. And in making such a profession of faith, many of them reported having a deep encounter with God and an experience of their faith in Jesus Christ. Other students made the decision, which, of course, is never irrevocable, against belonging to the church. Well, the entire retreat process was based on the question Jesus asked in today's gospel: who do you say that I am? The disciples, as we heard, reflecting on their experiences with Jesus, offered various possibilities. But it was Peter who answered that Jesus is the revelation of God for the world. You are the Christ, he said, the Son of the living God. This was the first profession of faith and the basis on which the church came to be. Jesus needed to know if his chosen ones were grasping who he was and what his mission was. Only if they were getting it would there be hope for the church after he was gone. And what was true back then is true now. Are we getting it? What does God really mean to me? What does God really mean to you? And who is Jesus in our lives? It was with interest that I read how one man in the present era came up with some answers to these questions. His name is Jean-Paul Kaufmann, a French journalist who was abducted in Beirut in Lebanon in 1985 and spent 3 years in captivity. His time in solitary confinement gave him the opportunity, he said, to ponder questions about what life, and specifically what his life, was all about. And he called it his spiritual cleansing. He wrote, "The closeness of death hanging over me helped me put my thoughts in order. It enabled me to cleanse my soul. God became very significant for me. Never have I prayed with such intensity. In the darkness and silence, I felt close to God. This one and only uncreated, holy God, so far beyond the real understanding of humans, is the most impressive reality in the world, and yet so completely beyond the compass
of the human mind. And he was drawn by the challenge of that, by the challenge of that same question to Peter, "Who do you say that I am?" And in order to find an answer, he read and reread the Bible, one of only two books to which he had access, the other being Tolstoy's War and Peace. But Jean-Paul Kaufman claimed that had he not had this experience, he believed that he would perhaps have died in utter ignorance of the meaning of life in this world. St. Paul, in today's second reading, writing to the Romans, reminds them that even though human beings may not understand the ways of God, God is the beginning, the sustainer, and the end of all that is. So Jesus asks that question to finish. Jesus asks that question of each of us today. Who do you say that I am? Is Christ and following him more than a concept, more than rules to be followed, more than obligations to be kept? Do I have a personal relationship with Jesus? In other words, is Jesus real for me? Is Jesus real for you? How I and how you answer these questions will reveal so much, including whether Jesus Christ is an idea that we like or the object of our passion. And so he asks us again, who do you say that I am? A good question for the week ahead.
And now we stand as we profess our faith. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. Let us lift our earthly needs in prayer and discover God's redeeming love in our midst.
For our church, that we may proclaim by word and action the infinite love of God for all creation, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For peace in our nation and for peace in the world, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the victims of the fires in Maui and for all people who are suffering, that they receive the comfort the strength, and the help they need through our love and generosity. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our parish community and for continued guidance and success of our capital campaign and ministry center project. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our loved ones who have died, that they may journey home to heaven, aware of our love for them on earth. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For Robert Condello and Frank Reddington and Jillian McDonald, who we are remembering in a special way in this Eucharist. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the intentions of the parish prayer line, the intentions in the parish prayer boxes, and our own special intentions. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. Loving God, we give you thanks for your many blessings. We bring our needs to you again this morning, many private intentions coming from deep in our hearts, and we ask you to grant what we bring in faith through Christ our Lord. Amen. And just a reminder that there will be a second collection today, as we announced last weekend, and it's for the victims of the Maui fires. Thank you for your generosity.
Thank you.
Pray, my brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, our Almighty Father.
The Lord accept the sacrifice at your hand for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
Receive our oblation, O Lord, by which is brought about a glorious exchange, that by offering what you have given, we may merit to receive your very self through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
And lift them up to the Lord.
And let's give thanks to the Lord our God.
He is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For out of compassion for the waywardness that is ours, he humbled himself and was born of the Virgin. By the passion of the cross, he freed us from unending death, and by rising from the dead, he gave us life eternal. And so with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim.
Holy, holy, Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more, giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me."
The mystery of faith.
When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity together with Francis, our Pope, Frank, our local bishop, and all your ministers. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, remembering Robert Condelo, Frank Reddington, and Gillian MacDonald, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on each one of us, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, with Saint Michael the Archangel, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ.
Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever.
Amen, amen, amen.
The Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we now dare to pray as one. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Amen. And may the peace of the Lord be with each of you. And we offer each other a sign of Christ's peace.
Grant us
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are they who are called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed.
Long before the mountains came to be, and the land and sea, and stars of the night, through the endless seasons of all time, you have always been. You will always be in every age. Oh God, you have been our refuge in every age. Oh God, you have been our destiny is cast, and at your silent word, we return to dust and scatter to the wind. 1,000 years are like a single moment gone, as the light that fades the end of day. In every age,
every age. O God, you have been our hope. Teach us to make use of the time we have. Teach us to be patient even as we wait. Teach us to embrace our every joy and pain, to sleep peacefully and to rise up strong in every age. O God, you have been our refuge in every age. O God, you have been our
practice of offering a blessing to any little ones who have yet to make to receive First Holy Communion. So they would like to come forward for their blessing. I always say that it's always wonderful to have so many little ones to bless. So thanks to mommies and daddies and all who make that possible. So we certainly appreciate it. Let us pray. Complete within us, O Lord, we pray, the healing work of your mercy, and graciously perfect and sustain us, so that in all things we may please you through Christ our Lord. Amen. Just two brief announcements. Our family formation class will begin Sunday, September 17th, immediately after the 10 a.m. Mass. The first communion class will begin Wednesday, October 4th at 4 p.m. And if you haven't enrolled your child or family yet, there is still time. And all families are welcome to join. There are details in the bulletin or contact the parish office. We've got new name badges for our ushers and greeters. We placed them in the ministry room just inside the front door of the church next to the sign-in sheet. If you haven't received yours yet, please go there and pick it up. And if you're an usher or a greeter and there is no name tag for you, please let us know and we'll get one for you. How many of you are visiting us this weekend? I think quite a number. Okay, well, it's wonderful to have you. Thank you for sharing this Sunday morning with us. It's always nice to be able to host our visitors when you're on the quay or in Sarasota. So thank you. So let's pray in the coming week that the approaching storm may not do a lot of damage to any community. So we pray for that. The Lord be with you. May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Our Mass is ended. Let's go in peace to love, to serve the Lord. Have a blessed week, everyone. Thank you.
Awake from your slumber. Arise from your sleep. A new day is dawning for all those who weep. In darkness have seen a great light. The Lord of our longing has conquered the night. Let us build a city of God. May our tears be turned into dancing, for the Lord our light and our love has turned the night into day. We are sons of the morning. We are daughters of day. The one who has loved us has brightened our way. The Lord of all kindness has called us to be a light for his people, to set their hearts free. Let us build a city of God. May our tears be turned into dancing, for the Lord our light and our love has turned the night into day. Thank you.
time you're raising.
Get my report.